Very good morning, cadets. Hope you are doing well. Today, let me start a chapter from Democratic Politics, Part 1. Part 1, you are studying in class 9th, and Part 2, you are studying in class 10th. So chapter number 1, that is, what is democracy, why democracy? Now, the word democracy is of course a common word because you may be heard many times. But can you define democracy? That is what is democracy? The meaning of the term democratic government, that is, what is democracy? The next question arises here, why only democracy? Why not kingship? Why not communist rule? Why not the dictatorship? Why not the autocracy? Why only the democracy? So, the chapter 1 is a chapter to try to solve the problem of what is democracy. That means we are going to study the meaning of democracy in detail, the democratic form of government, that is called meaning of democracy. Then we are also going to study about why we should have democratic form of government, why not the other types, that is what, why democracy and what is. So there are two types of government exist in the world. One is democratic setup of government, second one is non-democratic form of government. So kingship, dictatorship, communist form of government, all other forms of government be boxed under one, and they are all called as non-democratic form of government. And all other means we divided the forms of government into two, that is democratic and non-democratic form of government. Please write down the definition of democracy. What is a democracy? So democracy is a form of government in which rulers are elected by the people. So one simple definition of democracy. What is the one simple definition of democracy? That in a democracy, rulers, for example, in India, prime minister, ministers, cabinet ministers, council of ministers, they are all the rulers. The rulers are not got their power or receive their power from hereditary, like Akbar, Babur, Jahangir. They all receive their power in a hereditary manner, means father to son. But in a democratic form of government, rulers are elected by the people. It is we who elected our MPs or MLAs. That is what democracy is, a form of government in which rulers are elected by the people. Please note down the simple definition. Now let us go deeply into the features of democracy. What are the features of democracy? Features means what are the common characteristics, features which we can see in a democratic form of government. So the first which we started with the definition. What is the definition we started? Democracy is a form of government in which rulers are elected by the people. So rulers are elected by the people. That is what the very, very simple and basic definition which we started. So in a democratic form of government, there is no hereditary transformation of power. For example, before Narendra Modi ji, Manmohan Singh was the Prime Minister of India. Once the Congress lost the election, BJP won the election, Narendra Modi ji became the Prime Minister of India. So like that, the political party which lost the power, naturally they may chair as a opposition party. The party which won the election definitely rulers. So that is what rulers are elected by the people. Now the question comes, who are the rulers? The officials to be elected for the government called democracy. So here rulers are, they are the people who may be taken elected officials in a democracy. Who are the rulers in this definition? Rulers are generally, you understand, they are the MPs, MLAs and the minister. They are all called as rulers. Now the second question comes here. Rulers are elected. Now when we speak elected, what kind of elections? So what kind of elections makes a democratic? For example, if during the election some political party spend money, bribes the people, gives costly gifts, threatens the people, is those elections are democratic? That's the question mark. So what, which elections? All elections cannot be called as democratic, because in China also there is a regular election, but they are not democratic elections. So we have to find a question, what makes a elections democratic? That is also we are going to study in this particular chapter. The next one which we are going to study is, who are the people who can elect the rulers? Take for example, in India, those who are above the 18 years of age, those who are above the 18 years of age, we have got voting right. So that is what we decide. Now whenever I say those who are above 18 years of age can vote, now please don't conclude it is same in all the countries. There may be few countries where the people are denied voting right. So even though we enjoy the universal adult franchise or the voting right in India, it may not be same in other countries. So that what we are going to study when we study in detail. Then finally, what kind or a form of government democracy is. So we are going to study who are the rulers, then we are going to study what kind of elections, then we are going to study who are the people involved in electing, and finally we are going to study what kind of government which is ruled. Now whenever we speak about India, naturally lot of discussion about Pakistan, because India and Pakistan of course got independent together because Pakistan is a part of India because of Muhammad Ali Jinnah, and is divided into India and Pakistan. And Pakistan also, they turned as a democratic government along with us. But unfortunately, every now and then Pakistan's democracy was under threat. I repeat, Pakistan's democracy was under threat because of military coup. Military coup means military rebellion, or military dictators overthrew the democratic government. When it is happened last? That is happened in 1999. Who done it? General Pervez Musharraf. So General Pervez Musharraf led a military coup in October 1999 and overthrew the democratically elected government and declared himself as chief executive of the country. Now compare this with this. Who are the democracy means rulers are elected by the people. Now you apply this here, in a democracy rulers are elected by the people, but what happened in 1999 in Pakistan? He declared himself as chief executive of the country. So naturally it is not democracy. That's why Pakistan turned into dictatorship in 1999. Please remember the date and please remember the name. Now not only Pakistan, the country is there in same in Myanmar. You see here caricature, one cartoon is there. This is about Syria. You see the goddess of democracy. So goddess of democracy, she is not allowed to enter inside. That is the condition of Syria. So they say that no entry before you fill that form and become the member of in Baath party. Is it clear? Now what it says that in Syria there is a political party. It is given here, Baath party, and this party is controlling entire the work of Syria, and this party is not allowing any democratic elections. That's why it is clear, see, the goddess of democracy is standing outside, and the dictator, you can see the military dictator is asking the goddess of democracy to fill the membership. So that is the condition in few countries. Here, this cartoon is about ballot box. Now this is a ballot box, this is a ballot box. But you see a person who is coming to vote in the ballot box, you can see gun is pointed towards him. So that means even though elections are conducted, do you think these elections are democratic? This is done in the situation of Pakistan, because General Pervez Musharraf, of course, allowed people to continue with the election, but those elections were all controlled by the military. So the first feature of democracy, what is the first feature of democracy? That in a democracy the final decision making power rests with the elected people. Of course this will come in detail when we proceed with the chapter. The features of democracy, what is the first one? The first feature of democracy is, please understand, major decisions by elected leaders. Take for example, yesterday Narendra Modi decided, and his cabinet decided, that those who are above 18 years of age, now mass vaccination against coronavirus will be done from 1st of May. So this is a major decision. Who took the decision? The decision is taken by the government. The government is elected by the leader people. So major decisions in a democratic country is always taken by the elected leaders, not the non-elected leaders. That the example, of course, about Pervez Musharraf's Pakistan is given here, that who attained power by using his military power. So that is what the first decision, first feature of a democratic country, that major decisions in a democracy is always taken by the elected leaders. You can quote n number of examples regarding India. What is second feature? Second feature of a democracy is free and fair electoral competition. Now what do you mean by free? Don't think free in the consumer point of view, something available free to us, that is free. It is not like that here. Free means free mind, that is called free. Means a person going for a polling booth without having any fear or prejudice or preoccupied thought. So not having prejudice or preoccupied thought, he is going free with a free mind. And fair electoral competition. Fair electoral competition means people are the representatives are contesting election in a fair manner, means without using any unfair methods like bribing the people, threatening people, giving gift to the people. Those all are considered as the part of unfair competition. Examples are given here. For example, you see, what is the example given here? The Chinese Communist Party. The Chinese Communist Party, only those who are the members of Chinese Party or eight similar parties allied are allowed to contest election to be held in 2002 and 2003, and government is always formed by the Communist Party. Now you see here, in Communist Russia, China, there is no free and fair election. Why? Because in China there is no other political party, only one party is there. Which is the party? The party is the Communist Party of China. So after every election, only the person will change, but the party is always remains the same. That's why the government is always formed by whom? The Communist Party. So it is not a fair election. At the same time, the people who are not allowed to make their own political party, rather only the members of the Communist Party can contest for election. So that's what it is, not a democratic election. See, in the case of Mexico, please be with me. Mexico hold election after every 6 years to elect the president. The country has been never under military dictator rule, but until 2000, every election was owned by whom? Every election in Mexico was owned by a party called PRI, that is Institutional Revolutionary Party. Opposition parties did contest, but PRI party always managed to win. So PRI was known for use many dirty tricks to win the election. So in Mexico also regular elections are conducted, but elections cannot be called as free and fair. Why? Because always the PRI political party wins. They use all the dirty tricks. For example, you see, all the government employees had to attend the party meetings. Teachers of the government school used the forced parents to vote for PRI. Media largely ignored the activities of opposition political parties. So now you see, media is against the opposition parties, government employees are opposition against the opposition parties. So finally, for namesake, there is a party in Mexico, but always the PRI wins. So that is not a free and fair electoral competition. Third feature is very interesting, that is one person, one vote, one value. It's a very, very simple it may looks, but you have to understand in a very deeper manner. One person, one vote, one value. For example, if I go for voting or casting my vote and even the Prime Minister or the President vote is got the same value. That is one vote, one value. I am the one person. So that's what, one person, one vote, one value. But there are many countries in the world where this policy of one person, one vote, one value is not followed. In India, of course, we follow universal adult franchise, in which one person, one vote, one value is followed. Countries which don't follow this, you see, until 2015, Saudi Arabia, in Saudi Arabia, women did not have a right to vote. So the question of one person, one vote, one value is not there, because women are not they were not enjoying voting power. What is second? Estonia, you see, Estonia has made its citizenship rule in such a way that people belonging to Russian minority, they find it difficult to get right to vote. So in Estonia, only Estonians, the people of that particular country, they get voting right, whereas the minority Russians who are settled down in Estonia, they are not getting right to vote. So one person, one vote, one value is not there. Apart from that, you can see one more example in Fiji. In Fiji, the electoral system is such that one vote of an indigenous Fiji was more value than Indian Fijian. So a person who is from India settled down in Fiji, his vote got less value than a person who originally belongs to the country called Fiji. So there are many countries, including Sri Lanka, that one person, one vote value is not practiced even in Sri Lanka. The two features which we studied, the first, the one is democracy. In a democracy there must be elections which should be free and fair, where those currently in power have a fair chance of losing election. That is what democracy. Anybody can become a ruler, any party can become ruling party, or any party can become opposition party. That's a beauty of democracy. At the same time, one more feature what we studied, democracy, in a democracy every adult citizen must have one vote, one value, and one person. So one person, one vote, one value. So these are the important features of democracy. This chapter is very well there for your monthly test. Take care. Wish you a wonderful day. Thank you.